الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك فقنا عذاب النار.
الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala abundantly the way He deserves to be praised. And we ask Allah to exalt the mention and grant peace and send His salutations and His blessings upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us valuable lessons. He gave us advice. He gave us direction. He gave us guidance. And Allah azza wa jal made the proof and the evidence for loving Allah in the following of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Say, if you truly love Allah, then follow me. As in the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah will love you and will forgive you your sins. And this is a beautiful thing, wallahi. If someone wanted to prove their love for Allah, then it is in following the guidance of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam did not leave us without guidance. As mentioned by one of the Sahaba, it's Abu Dharr, if my memory serves me well, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam passed away and there wasn't even a bird that flaps its wings in the sky, except that he gave us some knowledge of that. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam gave the Muslims all the knowledge which was needed for them to get closer to Allah. Nothing that will get you close to Allah except that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam guided us to it. What is our problem? Lack of knowledge. Second, if knowledge is there, lack of application. And the third is innovations. People sidelining the sunnah and considering it to be extreme and preferring some other humans' ideas and innovations and ideologies instead and presenting them as an alternative for the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Once we started doing that, then we had people going astray. And we just want to go back to the path that is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so we can attain success in this life and in the life to come. Today, insha'Allah ta'ala, or in this episode, we will be dealing with a very particular hadith and a dhikr wherein we learn how to seek refuge in the words of Allah. We seek refuge in the words of Allah. Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu wa ardah reported that a man went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, O Messenger of Allah, I am severely ailing due to a scorpion bite from yesterday. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you had said, A'udhu bi kalimatillahi attammati min sharri ma khalaq, it would not have harmed you. If you had said, when going to sleep, I seek refuge in the complete words of Allah from the evil that he created, it would not have harmed you. Subhanallah. And we see now people getting harmed in all types of ways, and we wonder the source, or how come we weren't protected. Well, that's one of the reasons, is because we did not apply this particular dhikr that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam taught the ummah to engage in. At-Tirmidhi reported from Suhail ibn Salih, from his father, may Allah have mercy on them, who reported from Abu Hurairah, may Allah be pleased with them, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, whoever says when going to sleep, I seek refuge in the complete words of Allah from the evil that he created, three times, they will not be affected or harmed by a sting during that night. Suhail said, our family learned it and they used it, and they used to say it every night. A young girl was stung one night but did not feel any pain from it. And so this is the iman of the Sahaba. This is the difference between us and them in so many ways. You remember the hadith of the man that had some stomach ache, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told his brother to give him honey, and then it wouldn't get fixed, and he gave it to him multiple times, and he told him that the issue is not with the honey. Because Allah says the honey is shifa. The issue is with the person himself. Your brother does not have that commitment. He doesn't have that iman, that faith in Allah that it will be useful, that it will protect them. And a lot of us say certain adhkar while we are reluctant, meaning our state of iman is one where we're not 100%. We're not even 70%. You know, we're 50%, and then we say, how come it didn't work? Subhanallah. Because there's no true commitment. So these things like ruqya, anything has to do with ruqya, which is like the remedy, the spiritual remedy. Excuse me, for any type of disease or any type of ailment and so on and so forth. A lot of people who engage in it almost don't believe that they will be cured. And as a result of that, they don't. Because Allah taught us in the Hadith Qudsi that أَنَا عِنْدَ ظَنِّ عَبْدِ بِي, I am whatever my slaves think of me. فَلْيَظُنِّ بِي مَا يَشَاءَ, let him think whatever he wants. So if you want to think good about Allah, then you will get it. If you want to assume something bad, then you will also get that. It becomes our responsibility to have iman, have faith, have trust in Allah Azza wa Jal, that when we make these adhkar, we will be protected accordingly. We will be protected bi-idhnillah Azza wa Jal accordingly. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah had a comment on this. He said, seeking refuge cannot be done through something created, as Imam Ahmad and other scholars have stated. So they used to use this hadith as evidence to show that the speech of Allah is not created. And since it has been established in the Sahih book and other places that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say, I seek refuge in the complete words of Allah from the evil that he created, they said seeking refuge cannot be in something created. And this is an important lesson, because today if you ask the Muslims, you know, they believe that the Quran is created. And as we know, Al-Quran kalamullah minhu bada wa ilayhi ya'ud. The Quran is the speech of Allah. From Allah it began and to Him it will return. And so it is غَيْرُ مَخْلُوقٍ, it is not created. The speech of Allah is one of His attributes. Otherwise, it would be impermissible to seek refuge with Allah from something He created. Therefore, when you say أَعُوذُ بِكَلِمَاتِ اللَّهِ التَّامَّاتِ, when you seek refuge in the words of Allah, the complete words of Allah, is an evidence that it is an attribute of Allah. Otherwise, it wouldn't be possible that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would teach the Ummah anything which negates monotheism. The whole religion came for us to say, La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. There's no deity worthy of worship except Allah. And that means we negate any type of polytheism, whether it is major or minor or subtle or vivid or hidden, it does not matter. The religion was based on Tawheed, and this is one of those evidences. So I remind my brothers and sisters about the importance of learning these adhkar and applying them. So when you go to a place, when you go to the desert, when you go to, maybe you want to go to the sea, to the ocean, you go to a place where you're settling down, it is important to say this dhikr so that you can be protected bi-idhnillah azza wa jal from any harm. But don't just say it with your lips while your heart is not in the state of contentment and affirmation. Say it with a heart that believes and a tongue, and then bi-idhnillah azza wa jal, you will be granted what you've been promised. Jazakum Allah khair. See you in the next episode, inshaAllah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك فقنا عذاب النار